Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. So this is a very important topic, and I'm very happy to see all of you here this morning or during this noon time to discuss the rise of alternative facts, which unfortunately have always existed but have exacerbated in the past, maybe I'd say year and a half, in particular during the U.S. elections. And I might as well walk around calling myself alternative facts, because the coordinated right wing has actually engaged in an attack of using alternative facts against me in particular, things that are absolutely baseless. So we may say, oh, well, alternative facts, you know, I think I know the difference. Unfortunately, the point of alternative facts is oftentimes you do not know the difference. So I will just say, as someone who engages as a media commentator and also on social media, the tone that I've taken and the approach that I've taken to expressing my voice has been two ways. One is speaking from the personal. I am not interested in Muslims who say that they speak on behalf of all Muslims. I don't speak on behalf of 1.7 billion Muslims. I know some of you wish I did, but I don't. I speak on behalf of myself and the experiences and the stories that impact me as an individual and those that I work with. We have to be very careful about trying to speak on behalf of one of the world's most diverse religions. We have people of different racial backgrounds, socioeconomic backgrounds, people come from different parts of the world. Just because I'm Muslim doesn't mean I can speak on behalf of what's happening in Bangladesh or what's happening in Iraq. So we need to be really clear as Muslims, as we center the voices of those in our community, that we make sure that we're hearing directly from those who are being impacted. That's how we help with deciphering alternative acts. So if we're talking about Syria, I want to hear Syrians. If we're talking about Pakistan, I want to hear Pakistanis. If we're talking about Somalia, I want to hear from the Somalis. So that's one way. The second thing is how we are and how we engage in the media as Muslims, and also how to engage online on social media. I personally think that we Muslims need to be as unapologetic as the racists and the bigots. No need to use your social media to apologize for who you are or try to defend an act of terrorism, or to use your social media to only condemn terrorism when it happens in Europe or in the United States, but then you forget about your sisters and brothers in Pakistan or in Beirut or in Iraq. We as Muslims have a responsibility to use social media, right, to be consistent and authentic and ensure that we value all life. So oftentimes I see Muslims getting a little bit over dramatic when terrorist attacks happen in the West, but are silent when their own Muslim sisters and brothers are being massacred. So what I will say to you is, from my personal perspective, is that social media is an open platform. Nobody could tell you what to write on social media. The New York Times can't cut your quotes up. And it is your opportunity to speak truth to power, which is exactly what our deen tells us to do. Last thing I'll say about alternative facts is that you also have a role. If you read an article and you do not know what that outlet is, you never heard of it, it's probably something you want to look into more. If you also do not share articles based on a headline, because you read a headline and then you just shared it and you never read the article, because you yourself may be helping by spreading fake information that could potentially be harmful to our communities or other communities.